Hey, what is going on, guys? And welcome to our 47th in-depth character review, where today we are reviewing Sabine Wren. Sabine Wren is one of the more interesting Phoenix characters we have in the game, and with the Thrawn event coming sometime in the future, many of us are wondering if she is worth getting. But before we do that, let's talk about the history of Sabine Wren in the Star Wars universe. Prior to becoming a rebel, Wren was a cadet at the Imperial Academy of Mandalore. She built weapons she believed would be used for peace, but were instead used against her family and her people. Filled with guilt, she left Mandalore and was branded as a traitor by the Empire and her mother, who was the leader of the clan. For a period of time, she worked as a bounty hunter and eventually joined Hera Syndulla and Kanan to be a part of the Phoenix Squadron. Together, the crew fought against the Empire, and Sabine's artistry became a symbol of hope for the rebellion. Eventually, Sabine did return to her family with the Darksaber she recovered from Dathomir, with the goal of freeing all of Mandalore from the grip of the Empire. With the history out of the way, let's talk about the free-to-play way to farm Sabine Wren, and as of now, there is only one method, and that is through the Guild Store. For 400 Guild currency, you can get 5 shards of Sabine Wren, so she will be a little harder to farm compared to other characters in the game. Sabine is quite a unique character when it comes to her kit, but before we look at her kit, let's take a look at her stats before considering mods and abilities, and let's dive straight into the pros, where she is seen as number 16 in speed, where she has 151 speed, and that ties her with Sith Assassin in this game. And the other pro to point out is her AoE ability is number 10, where she can do 3,391 damage. Let's move on over to the averages for this particular character, and Sabine Wren is quite average in a bunch of things for this game. First of all, number 69 in potency. She applies debuffs, so it is very important that she has decent potency, and she has about 29% potency, which is slightly above the average in the game. She is also quite average when it comes to health protection and combined health and protection, where for health, she is number 57, having 18,514 health. For protection, she is number 50, having 21,180 protection. And then for combined health and protection, she is number 51 in the game, having 39,694. And the last average thing that she has going for her is maximum damage, where she is number 61, and her maximum damage dealing attack is 5,261. And there is one more thing missing, but to find out what it is, we gotta talk about the stuff that Chewbacca wants to cry about. And that last thing is maximum basic damage, where she is number 80 in this game. Sabine Wren's maximum basic damage dealing attack is 3,961 damage. Not all that bad, especially once we look at her kit. And let's do that right now by looking at her kit and understanding how the numbers will work in application. The first thing that she has is her basic called Blasters Akimbo, and it is actually quite a cool basic to use. It deals physical damage to a single enemy twice, and this attack can score additional hits if certain conditions are met. If the enemy had less than 70% turn meter, she gets one more hit. If the enemy had less than 30% turn meter, you get one more hit. And if the target is debuffed, she gets one more hit. And hits after the first two times deal 75% damage. And in total, if all the conditions are met, she can hit up to 5 times. So when you take her basic damage of roughly 4,000 per hit, it could total up to 20,000 for one attack, and that is actually quite nice to use. But next up here is probably one of the more interesting things about her. It's called Dark Saber Strike. Has a very low cooldown of 2 turns, and what it does is that it deals physical damage to a single enemy and inflicts a new thing called Armor Shred for the rest of the battle. Armor Shred is unique to only Sabine Wren at this time, and Armor Shred is not considered a debuff and it cannot be resisted or dispelled. In addition, its effects stack but are halved against units with the Fearsome Foe ability, such as the Rancor, and what Armor Shred does is that it reduces the defense by 50% per stack, can't be dispelled, and as I said earlier, it is not a debuff. We'll talk more about the usefulness later on, but let's move on to Demolish. It has a higher cooldown of 5 turns, no Omega Mats needed for this particular ability, and this deals physical damage to all enemies, and you expose and stagger the targeted enemy for 2 turns, and this attack cannot be countered or evaded. And lastly, we have the ability called
Take It Back!
This is her unique ability. It is quite simple, but it also can deal quite a punch. Sabine has plus 25% critical chance and has a plus 25% critical damage. So a lot of great things. We'll talk about how to use this to your advantage, but let's quickly look at her gear requirements before going any further. She is about average to gear compared to other characters in the game. She's actually very similar to Ezra Bridges' requirement. She's right on average, needing 3 pieces of Rancor gear, needs 2 pieces of AAT raid gear. Gold gear, pretty much the same. You will need 2 pieces of gold gear to get from gear 10 to gear 11, and then 2 more gold pieces once you're at gear 11. And for purple gear, she is number 63 in this game, where she will need 1,145 pieces, and she needs kind of the same things as Ezra: 200 Mark III carbontes, 150 Mark VI hyposyringes, and 100 Mark V stun guns are some of her most popular purple pieces you will need. So with all that being said, let's go and dive into my personal opinion of this character, some subjective thoughts, as well as some strategies, best friends, mortal enemies, you know the drill from here. And pretty much, out of all the Phoenix characters in the game as of now, Sabine is arguably the second best, with Ezra being the best Phoenix character. Ezra and Sabine are both great characters early on in the game especially. However, towards the more advanced stages, Ezra continues to be decent, but Sabine does not seem to be as useful for the more advanced players. For those more advanced players in the game, she continues to be a decent attacker with her damage output and the armor shred. That also does come in handy to slice through the armor of some characters. But for those who have tested her out and used her, provided gameplay, had a conversation with me, they do not think they are being better off by replacing someone in their arena team for Sabine Wren. For advanced players, they have to consider if they'll replace Chirrut, Baze, General Kenobi, Rex, Nihilus, Thrawn, R2-D2, many other characters, which are all amazing and do great things. Sabine does not seem to be at that level where she could be a very logical choice to replace any of those characters I just mentioned. But for mid-game players or even beginner players who get a hold of her somehow, she will be very useful. Most likely, those types of players will be using an Ackbar leadership or perhaps a Phoenix Squadron lineup, which is actually pretty solid before one reaches the advanced stages of the game. She can definitely help you win some battles, but you need to ask yourself that question. Should I put Sabine Wren over my geared up Darth Nihilus that I have? That is pretty much the question. She is definitely a good arena character by all means. But aside from this arena analysis that I've been giving so far, she is a pretty good character for the AAT raid in phases 2 and phases 3, and a counter-attacking team for phase 1, as we see from some of the footage I provided you from MCMOL 2 that showcases how fresh she is looking. Her multiple attacks translate into a lot of damage being piled up on the tank. Armor Shred, this is where Armor Shred comes in. It allows your allies to push out more damage than they would otherwise, which comes in handy when trying to take down a turret quickly or when the tank is down. You can get some big damage piled up, like Ezra and the other Phoenix characters. Sabine does not need an Omega upgrade on her Demolish ability, and she has no Zeta abilities whatsoever of some sort. So perhaps with an Omega upgrade on Demolish and some Zeta upgrades like the other Phoenix characters, she can be a really great character for the advanced player in Arena. But even outside of that, as I said, she is great for the AAT raid and especially helpful to knock out the Emperor Palpatine and the Thrawn legendary events. But for top people in Arena, it takes more than just good damage to be useful. But let's move on to the mortal enemies, some things you need to watch out for when using Sabine Wren. And the number one thing are anti-critical damage characters. They will be an issue since she relies heavily on applying critical damage. So that means if you're going up a Rex lead, she will feed a lot of Termeter to the enemy, or perhaps she will not be able to apply as much damage because of critical hit immunity. Anti-rebel characters such as Thrawn, as well as Death Trooper, or perhaps General Veers, Tenacity Up prevents the debuffs from her Demolish ability from applying and will also reduce the number of hits she can apply on her basic. No debuffs means one less attack. Fast characters that can also manipulate Termeter will reduce the number of hits on her basic. If characters are getting above 70% Termeter really fast, she will not be able to apply as many attacks. And then of course, ability block, stun, and cooldown increases will prevent her from using her specials against you as often as she should. For the best friend segment, there are actually a lot of ways to use her, but characters that amplify her damage output are strongly preferred, such as Wedge. Rebel characters work very nicely due to the variety of bonuses they provide to each other, especially when in the Phoenix Squadron. Characters that can call assists or grant Sabine perhaps retribution is deadly to make her get as many attacks off as possible. Pairing up some big damage dealers with Sabine Wren might actually be a pretty good idea. Because of Armor Shred, you can churn out some more damage, and Armor Shred will just reduce the armor of your enemies, and that way pull out some more damage and knock out characters or perhaps turrets from the AAT rate a lot faster. Now, one of my favorite lineups for Sabine Wren is an Akbar leadership alongside some other great rebels such as Biggs, Wedge, and Ezra due to all the bonus attacks they are generating and all the big damage. And of course, a Wedge lead is especially great with Sabine because more damage churning out of that basic attack. Now let's take a look at the mods. As I said, we have to keep her unique in mind because she loves critical chance and critical damage. For the mod set, you're going to focus on critical chance and critical damage as your number one priority. But if you don't have those, offense is a great number two choice because both pair nicely with her great damage output and her unique. Tenacity and speed are good third and fourth options to ward off debuffs a little bit and make her more faster, meaning she gets off more basic attacks in battle and applies that armor shred to a lot of enemies. Then when you're examining the primary and secondary mods, speed is a number one priority for this character, as well as critical damage mods, so she is applying armor shred as frequently as possible, getting big damage in as much as possible, and critical damage is especially important since she already gains 25% critical damage from her unique. And then protection is an excellent choice to increase her already decent defensive capabilities. Potency mods can be helpful to apply expose and stagger more frequently, but they are not as important as the other options I kind of gave you. And lastly, we have Yoda's do or do not checklist. And when you're looking at this list, guys, she is pretty much a do for every single thing. Arena, she is great. All that jazz. She has a ship. It's called the Phantom 2. You could also use her for the Rancor raid. No, she does not remove Terminator, but she can help put out some big damage. An example might be Wedge, Biggs, Sabine, Jin, and Bastan. That's a great Rancor raid team because it combines Terminator removal and a ton of damage output. And she will be phenomenal for the AAT raid. Phase 4, she is great for a rebel lineup. She can work in a clone lineup, oddly, for Phase 2. And if you have a counter-attacking team, Phase 1 will be an excellent choice for Sabine Wren because she will counter General Grievous and get off a lot of bonus attacks on him. So with all that being said, let's pull up that Hall of Fame and rank Sabine Wren from Grandmaster to Youngling. Sabine Wren is going to be ranked as a Knight. Sabine is a really cool character and one of the more useful Phoenix characters we got in this game. She is a great attacker, but beyond that, she does not really give you too much else to work with besides the good damage output. Yes, she can win battles in arena, but there are many more options out there that could do far more than her, as well as keeping that damage output. But she is highly recommended for early people in this game and will knock out the Palpatine and Thrawn legendary events with absolute ease. But seeing that she is in the guild store, I highly recommend not farming her right away. Focus on characters like Rex and Jin because they are far superior characters, have more use, and Sabine Wren is definitely a good choice once you farm those first few important characters. And on that bombshell, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and learned something about Sabine Wren. If you did enjoy this video, please leave me a like. Also, comment down below on what our next in-depth character review should be, and be sure to subscribe so you're not missing a thing. Check out my Patreon page for early access to these videos, as well as the graphics, or even meet up with me on a monthly basis. But until then, we will talk again very soon. Peace out.